In today's video, I'm going to be breaking down John Beast's incredible route, and I think one of his best plays, and actually was one of Drini's best plays as well, but John Beast used it for multiple different looks. It was a very good play out of Gun Bunch. We're going to break it down here in just a second. Now, if you've never been to my channel before, my name's Cody, and I make videos that are designed to help you get better on the offensive side of the ball and on the defensive side of the ball in Madden NFL 21. So if you haven't subscribed yet, I upload daily tips and tricks videos that are designed to do just that. So make sure to go ahead and click that subscribe button in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. And we're going to jump right in here. So John Beast and Drini both did this a lot. John Beast actually did this a little bit more against Joke because Joke was running a little bit more man coverage. The meta shift right now in Mutt is to run man coverage. That is the meta. It is shaded down, two man under, user the middle, and just bag people, right? That's what everybody is doing right now in the world of Madden 21. So John Beast actually, and it's a very it's super simple way to beat man coverage out of the Gun Bunch. So we're gonna jump right into right into it here. But you'll notice, like, right in this possession series, he's going to do this. Now, again, a lot of people like to use Playmaker as well. Playmaker is a very good ability. It does help you really work well against man coverage. When the receiver's cutting to the right, you just flick the right joystick to the left and Playmaker and back across the field, and it does a really good job. But what you'll notice, maybe right here, it might be the next play, but John Beast will go to this over and over again in the red zone. Yeah, he's going to go to it right here. You see here this motion out, and you see that right there, that little angle, and he does miss the touchdown. So we're going to jump in and break this down. He should have got a touchdown on that play, but I want to break this down. A lot of people were saying, you know, this was a blind read. What is he thinking? Why would he throw this? This is exactly why, and we're going to jump right into it here. The play really is meant to be ran out of flood. You can run this out of other plays too, though, which is one of the reasons I think it makes it super successful. So I want to show you a couple different versions of running this play. Now, to show you this, I'm going to back the ball up. I'm going to kind of re-spot it here and just get things kind of cleaned up for you. But anyway, this is Bunch Offset. Now, if you want to get my full offense on Bunch Offset, just shoot me a text message. It's in my text membership, which my text membership, in a nutshell really quickly, is where I release full offenses and defenses every single week to my community. So if you want to sign up for that, just literally shoot me a text message. But here's what people would do out of this. So this is cover two man. This is man press. And I just want to show you what people will be doing. A lot of people will put purple zones out here, right? They'll put purple zones and they'll shade them at 20, 25 yards, or maybe even make them cloud flash, right? And they shade their coverage down, and it's really hard to beat. So let me show you what this play does for you. With Tavon Austin, it might not be as good, but you'll see that little, right? See that right there? See that little cut that he gets, and he torches it over the top? This is very consistent from Gun Bunch, especially with shaded down man-to-man coverage, because a lot of people like to shade down coverage. It's really consistent out of, honestly, several different types of strategies that people can use, because what really happens with this is it's simply an unbumpable route that beats the press. So you don't just need this route to Austin. In fact, you can do this out of several other plays. You saw that John Beast did it out of this play right here, Z spot and go with this setup, right? Or something as simple as this right here. Like, I saw John Beast do this very simple. I mean, very simple ways to run it. But what you'll see right here is that motion out, and you see how he gets inside position, and you can click on and make the user catch. It's a very consistent read against that shaded coverage down man coverage. Now, one of the things that I want to highlight really quickly is something that you need to be aware of, and that is simply what happens when they're running cover two man. Right, it's one thing when they're running zone, or not zone, but it's one thing when they're running cover zero. But what does it look like when they're running cover two man? Well, first and foremost, we're going to show you this out of curl flat play, and just keep it super simple. Just run it just like this right here, this motion out streak, and you see that you can kind of hit that. Now, it's a tight window, and in my opinion, it actually does a lot better in Mutt. The reason why it's better in Mutt is when you have someone, and I'm going to go ahead and sub Devontae Adams in that position. When you have a receiver that is 90 route running or higher at every threshold, that makes a big, big difference in terms of how well they're going to do at getting open for your offense. So that's just something to kind of keep in the back of your mind when you're running these schemes. Is any route that has a cut on it at all, you really want to be getting a receiver in that position that has over 90 route running. So, for example, here we'll show this again. And now we'll simply just go like a basic max protect scheme here. You know, very simple routes right here. But as you'll see with Devontae Adams, he's going to get better positioning, and it's a lot easier of a throw. You see that inside pass lead. That inside pass lead does not just work against the purple zone meta. It actually works against all of it, and that's what makes this so good. It works against shaded coverage down man coverage. That's the key, because that's what everyone's doing right now in Madden Ultimate Team, is they're shading their coverage down, and they're saying, beat me. I'm going to press you, and I'm going to have two safeties over the top to defend me deep, and as you can see there, you have a good shot. Now, in my opinion, this actually works even better if you use the play flood. This is when you use the play flood, I think it makes it work 1,000% better and much, much more consistently, in my opinion, because it has that little shimmy, that little quick cut. Now, you don't have to leave Tavon Austin on his route. If you want to clear space, that's completely fine. Just simply put him on a hitch route. This is a very simple route combo, but it's very effective from Gun Bunch. Watch here, the motion out. And you watch a little cut into the inside, click on, and you got a pretty good chance of beating that. Now, again, I didn't shade my coverage down there. The way to stop it is actually relatively simple. Just shade your coverage up. I mean, if you shade coverage up, you're going to be able to stop it. But that then opens up other things for your offense. And as you see here, if he gets the jam on him, that's where, you know, we don't want to have that. So that's just something that you have to monitor. Obviously, if they have their X factor, activated, you know, you don't necessarily want to mess with that. So that's just something you have to be mindful of. But again, it's this motion out streak. It doesn't always work, but as you see there, it does create some natural picks, some natural rubs for you to be able to hit other receivers as well in this offense. So this play is super effective, super effective. If they take the safety away. Like, let's say they get down and they want to go press man and they want to blitz you, right? This is another thing that people are doing. This is an automatic touchdown. Automatic touchdown. As you see right there, if they shake coverage down, you know, it's going to be a touchdown. One of the things I didn't hit on is one of my favorite ways to run this, and I haven't hit on this yet, is to actually run a curl route instead of a streak. I find it gets better separation. That's just my personal opinion. And so simply taking your back, you know, I would literally just block, max protect, put the flat route to Tavon Austin, motion Devontae Adams out, and watch the inside. You see he gets better. See how much more inside leverage he's going to actually get on that? That's just my personal advice to you, is especially if they're shading their coverage over top. If you notice that they start shading their coverage over top, I've found that motioning these curl routes are really, really effective for that, because they're open at 2 points. You see right there, see, I can throw that on the snapback animation that I'm going to be able to get. You know, so that's something that you can do as well. One other little quick pro tip for this is to do a hitch route and smart route it. So if I put Devontae Adams on a hitch route and I smart route it, you see it's going to go about 10 yards. Same kind of theory right here. Inside position, and you can get it. Now, the thing that you're going to have to practice with this is you're going to definitely have to practice the timing. The reason I like the curl route better than the streak is I think the curl route gives you much, much more answers. It's not as good as the streak is, but this setup right here is one of my favorite setups in the entire game. Just a hitch, a curl, and literally, you know, you're just throwing your curl routes. I think that's really, really tough to stop in this year's game. Another way to run this, and I saw Wesley do this, is to do something like this. So basically you're going to take Tavon Austin, put him on a slant, you're really anything that you want to do. But you've got that out route to the tight end. Tight end out routes are really, really good. But again, right there, click on, and I can go aggressive, catch that. The beauty of that is it's going to get underneath every zone as well, so you're going to be able to have a zone beater. So let's say that they, you know, kind of play a little bit of mind games on you, and they show man coverage, but really they're going to run zone coverage. Again, that's where I really like this setup right here. It's very similar in the way it works, but as you can see, it's very, very effective against zone. So, you know, that way you have a man and a zone beater as well. But another, you know, anything really that has inside leverage is going to work with this. It's not just streaks. You can do this with other things as well. So just kind of keep that in the back of your pocket or the back of your head with these shaded coverage outside. So, for example, another thing that you could do, Davante Adams has route technician. So I could put him on a wide receiver outside wide receiver apprentice, right? So I can put him on this post route, and I could motion him outside, and watch, he's going to get automatic inside position every single time. That's what I'm talking about. In breaking patterns, whether it be a streak, a curl, a hitch, anything that breaks to the inside is going to be effective. A fade route, you'll notice, is not going to be as effective. Why? Because it's an outside releasing type of route. So if they're running cover two man, if you watch, this route to Adams, if he's running cover two, he should be able to get inside. And when he gets inside, there's no way for me to get him the ball. You see that right there? So what I've got to do as the offensive player is I've got to say, okay, I've got to get him inside leverage. How do I do that effectively? You can do that with any inside breaking pattern. It's not just a streak. A streak works, but it's not just a streak. You can use things like a smart routed in route, right? Most people probably haven't talked to me about this, but a smart routed in route right here, watch, inside position, I can throw it inside. And again, he has his X factor and all that stuff. So, you know, be mindful of this. But, you know, if you have motion up post route, you know, really anything, I think it's a super, super important thing to talk about. And I actually really like to do this concept out of curl flat, because the streak really provides a nice opportunity for you to be able to not only open up your streak, but also open up your corner route as well. So anyway, this is one of the plays that John Beast ran that really caught my eye. I think it caught a lot of people's eye. That's how he did it. Motion out streaks, motion out fades, really, really effective against the coverage, our cover two man press coverage meta with the one step ahead. A lot of people, when they run that specific defense, will, you know, not necessarily have an answer for this right here, as long as you make the user catch yourself. You got to user catch it yourself. You click circle, click onto the replayer, and you're going to make a play. And, you know, again, this is, you know, I mean, lab it up. It's not going to work every time, but the better the route running of the receiver, the better it's going to work. Sometimes you'll get swatted if they have, you know, some ability like deep out KO. If they have that, you might get swatted. So I wouldn't necessarily say it's like a go-to money play. I would simply say, you know, just run it in moderation, test it out, but do realize, like, it does work. But anyway, as you see there, you also have that big, nice little in route on the back side of it. So that's all I got for you today. If you want to get the full bunch scheme, text me. My number is 812-216-3644. Thanks for your time. I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you enjoyed the MCS. I thought there were some really, really good games this weekend. And we got some good ones lined up here in the next couple weeks. So really excited to watch Henry. He's probably my favorite player to watch just because of how innovative he is. But anyways, guys, if you have any questions, you can always text me. And if you want to get my full ebooks, they're in the description. But if you want to get my my bunch scheme, it's in my text membership. Just shoot me a text. My number's in the description. Thanks for your time, and we'll see you guys tonight on stream at 10 o'clock p.m. Eastern Time.